Okay, unfortunately, this is very loamy soil. You can see the type of soil. And that's not going to offer much support to this this slab. So I think I'm better off putting the crushed rock, you know, 600 millimeters out along this edge and carrying it all the way through. Okay, so when digging this channel for the road base, unfortunately I did hit the plastic pipe. Now there's a bit of a story behind that. I did find the remnants of a sprinkler system just here, and so I thought this plastic pipe was the old plastic pipe going to the sprinkler system, but this is the pipe, the plastic pipe that they've used to bring the water to the tap and then branch off that. Now the confusing thing is that we saw here how they matched up their copper pipe to my copper pipe here at the join. And so I thought they'd used copper pipe, but there's plastic pipe. Now I'm not really used to working with plastic pipe, as in, you know, bringing water to a tap or anything like that. That was after my time in the trade. That they were just they had the very beginnings of it. Like, you know, I was working with some guys who practically rolled out the first plastic pipe to be used in housing. Now that being the case, I've actually hit it as it comes up the hill here. It looks like I could have hit it there as well. But the leak was here, so I had to turn off the actually it's there and there, so I'm gonna have to bring in a piece of pipe and replace this. Now I think that's going to be very expensive, but anyway, I have to offload the road base there. I'll offload it here, which has been prepared, and yeah, I'll have to go to the hardware shop. Just while I'm at it, we can see the condition there of the old probably metal, stainless steel, or you know, no doubt the inside of it's okay, but it's just that it's quite rusted out. Okay, so I capped it off with a push-on fitting, and I'm going to replace this section here. We have some PEX pipe. Have some joiners. We have these cutters here, so just to demonstrate how they work. So with these you have to pull them all the way back, and then that will cut the pipe. Okay, I think if you don't pull it all the way out, if you go that far out, well, anyway, once it didn't work and it only went to about there, but anyway, that's how it goes. Okay, and I've got this. Bad things don't usually happen to me twice, So now that I've struck the pipe, I'll cut these in half and lay these over the top of the pipe, so that next time somebody's digging, it'll probably be the next owner, they'll strike this, and then it'll be removable. These are really good joiners. They're not cheap. It would be cheaper to do it the old copper pipe and soldering way. But you just push the pipe in, and it sort of goes in two sections. It slots in and then goes further, and that's when it locks in. So, okay, let's get it fixed. Okay, I've got some tape on one end, that's so that no dirt gets in. Okay, so I've worked out by putting an insert down into the end there that the pipe will go back 30 millimeters. Okay, so 30 millimeters is how far the pipe will go in. Okay, so that's approximately where that line is. Okay, so there's just a bit of copper in this area, of course, as part of the body. But that's what we're looking at, is 30 millimeters of pipe past this point, plus a bit of slack, so it can be pushed in. this cutter was about $17.50. It does have a habit of not quite cutting the pipe, so I've got that fully extended so far as I can tell. And you know, it has gone in here all the way, however it does have a habit of, under extreme pressure, when cutting is crucial, it doesn't seem to cut all of the pipe. Now why that is, I don't know. This ratchet mechanism, I'm not really sure. However, having said that, it is very affordable and I won't be using it all that often, and it was greatly appreciated for me to get my hands on this. Okay, so the mains water is on now. So how I cut it was, I didn't actually go past this point, so the pipe will slide in very close to the middle here. Of course, there has to be some structure or metal in between the joining parts, but what I did was I just S'd it a bit, or brought it out here, or more along the lines of along out here, and then I did cut it. I marked it and cut it at this point, so that as I straightened the pipe out, it had plenty of travel to lock in. So that's fixed. I don't turn the mains tap on very much, otherwise you can get knocking in your plumbing system in the house, and it just puts extra pressure on the you know, say for instance washing machine, etc. So okay, well, you know, that's plastic pipe and joiners, very good product. And I think, I'm not sure, I'll just see if I can get this out and what I have to do. I think they're reusable, but please do your own homework. Okay, I was able to get this piece of plastic out of the end cap. So I just latched onto it with these holders, and I got this. And what you do is you press back on the fitting. So, but what happened is this bit popped out. So that should just go back in there like that. Now we'll put this piece on just to see. Yep, that does seem to be reusable. That's hold. I can't get that out. So what I did was, you can look this up. There's information on the internet. So this bit here that's sticking out, you put an adjustable spanner on that, and you push that in. Push that piece of plastic in. So I'll just try it. It probably won't work this time, but we'll give it a go. Okay, so that was less dramatic. The piece stayed in there this time. As we can see, we can just push it back in and reuse it. Okay, and that seems really good. Good product. Thank you. Okay, well, it's the 22nd of the 10th, so we're getting closer to Christmas. Now, with this home improvement, what I have to do is just level this out. Probably see that it's a bit lower just there, but it's